Well, Mary, I have been looking forward to meeting you because, unfortunately, when you were in television, we were at different networks.
Right.
So I never had a chance to meet you doing any television promotion.
Well, I'm glad to meet you now.
But last night was such a thrill, really, to be here for the premiere of 6 Weeks, a beautiful premiere for the American Diabetes Association, which I have an affinity for as well.
You do?
Yes, no personal involvement,
yes.
It's just that I have a great affinity for
Well,
it.
As a diabetic and on behalf of everybody else, thank you for your interest.
And then to see you there looking so smashing and your escort, Steve Martin, it was just, it was a thrill.
It was a wonderful evening for me, too. It's not the kind of thing I look forward to. Premieres, you know, have such attention and spotlight, and I'm not always comfortable. But that was kind of a special group. I had a good time.
Yes, and you and Steve Martin had to be the most handsome couple there.
Well, thank you, but I think my mother and father would argue that point. They think they are.
Is the Inquirer now going to make a big thing? Are we going to see a big banner headline about Mary Tyler Moore?
Probably. They don't miss a trick, do they? I just, that's one aspect of my life that I really loathe, that invasion of personal privacy.
Yes, and I must tell you, Mary, that honest journalists like myself, people who really try to be fair and honest, I have never read a copy of that magazine simply because I so thoroughly disapprove
Good
of,
for you.
Of what they do.
And hear that out there? Don't buy it and don't believe a word of what you read.
Let's talk about your role in 6 Weeks because one might wonder why you would take two serious roles like that back-to-back, ordinary people in 6 Weeks.
Well, you know, everybody has this conception of there being 1,000 wonderful scripts out there to choose from. And it's not right. It's not the truth. In fact, a good script is very hard to come by. And so it was just coincidence that they were two dramatic roles. I'd love to do a comedy again. I have, in fact, two actually in development now that I hope will be ready in the spring, both comedies. I'm anxious to get back to it. I miss it. Although I must say it's been great excitement for me doing something different.
This young lady in the movie, Catherine Healy, of course, is primarily a dancer, but
yeah.
Does a super job.
Wasn't she extraordinary?
Yes. But I wonder also, looking at her, does it take you back to your own girlhood?
Yes, it does. It does. And it takes me back to a decision I made at about her age, and that was that the life of ballet dancer is so restrictive that I wasn't prepared to dedicate myself in the way Catherine is. And she truly wants to be a ballet dancer and not an actress. It could change, but I doubt it. And that's a very insulated kind of life. And one that I wasn't suited for, I knew at that point. So I threw away the point shoes and started taking tap and a couple of other lessons.
And then, of course, eventually acting just took over completely, didn't it?
Yes, it did. I started out in the chorus, and they would give me lines to do now and then, little tiny parts. And I knew that my dream of being a dancing actress was not going to come to pass because they just weren't making that kind of movie anymore. And so I thought, well, kid, you better get yourself an agent and fake your way through it, because I had no experience and no training. But I just, I'm an observer of life, and I'm free enough to express what I see, and it worked. I got lucky. I worked a lot.
Mary, some of the scenes in this movie, and we don't want to give away too much of the plot, and certainly not the ending, but you have some very heavy scenes
mm-hmm.
in this movie. Now, was that difficult for you? What I'm trying to say is, did it, when you would have to look within yourself and bring out these emotional feelings,
mm-hmm.
did it get to be too heavy for you some days?
It got to be as heavy as it would be in real life, and you must, as an actor, always make it that. You look at the situation and you completely submerge yourself in it, and it must be painful. The tears must be real. Actors use different techniques. Some actors draw on experiences or something they've read or told, and I like to work just with the situation at hand and really lose myself in it, which I did. So yes, it was painful, and that's as it should be, appropriate feelings.
I hear, though, that Dudley was always there to kind of break the tension.
Yes, he was wonderful fun. I mean, just so superior as a dramatic actor, and I knew he was going to be, and a very deep and thoughtful human being, but always there with a laugh.
I have a question that I'm asking everybody, Mary, because we are getting close to Christmas. Mm-hmm. And the question is this. If you could have anything in the world, some tangible thing, we all want good health and peace mm-hmm. and love, but some tangible thing, if you could have anything in the world, and money were no object,
yes.
what would you most like to have?
I would like to have the ability to convince my family and friends not to give me anything for Christmas. Because I just moved to a New York apartment and I don't have the space for anything else.
Not even some tiny little gem.
No, nothing.
Well, then maybe what you need is a bigger apartment.
Maybe that's it. Yes. No, please, it took a year and a half to get this one in shape. And the list keeps growing of things that need adjusting and fixing and what. No, I think I'll stay here for some time.
Are you in any way at all still involved with MTM?
Oh, yes, of course. Of course, I was never corporately involved on an official level, but those people who are running MTM keep me abreast of all the major important decisions, and we do talk, communicate a lot.
Well, Mary, again, I have enjoyed so much, finally, after all these years,
thank you.
Getting a chance to meet you.
It was very nice meeting you, too.
Congratulations on a really splendid performance.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mary. Nice interview. Okay, now I need to kind of, oh, my goodness, this is a luxury we're not accustomed to. Okay, and if you'll cut me above the waist, just crop out the notes, okay?
And No.
Okay. I mean, that's kind of you, but we're working quick and dirty today.
Okay.
All right, is this a good fix about here? Or
yeah,
more
here? Probably a little more to your right.
Here, okay? All right, a few reactions first. All right, sound for questions, please. It was such a thrill to be here for this premiere for the American Diabetes Association. And you and Steve Martin, you had to be the most handsome couple there. Is this now going to be a banner headline in the National Enquirer, Mary Tyler Moore and Steve Martin? I must tell you, I have never read that paper because I so thoroughly disapprove of their type of journalism. In Catherine Healy, Mary, do you see somewhat of your own past there? What made you decide then to give up the dancing? Some of your highly emotional scenes, Mary, and the sadness that you were going through in your character, did that get to be too heavy for you sometimes? But then there was always Dudley to break the tension, wasn't there? Are you still connected in any way at all with Mary Tyler? Are you still connected in any way at all with MTM? Mary, if you could have anything in the world for Christmas, money, no object, what would you most like to have? Maybe what you need is a bigger apartment. Okay, I believe that'll do it.
Okay,
thank you.
You're very good. You really...